Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, Tech Stuff with me, Tech Stuff Sakshit. And guys, today is a very special day because today is the happy birthday of our channel. It's been 1 year since I am running this channel, and I want to thank you, every one of you, for this support, great support to my channel, guys. And on this occasion, I'm gonna review a special smartphone. And when I say special, it's really, really special. So I'm not gonna reveal the name. I'll tell you in a few seconds. It's actually a very, it's like a mid-range killer. Now, as you can see, smartphones, most of the smartphones are coming in the mid-range, like the Redmi Note 10 Pro, Note 10 Pro Max, Realme 8, 5G, Nord C, Nord 2, all of these smartphones, they're mainly concentrating on the mid-range, okay? So, mid-range is actually very important, right? But now, I have a phone. It's a smartphone, of course. So, this is a low-end smartphone. It's about 10,000 and it's a mid-range killer. Guys, it's such a mid-range killer that it has all the specs of the mid-range smartphones, and in some aspects, it is even better than those mid-range smartphones. And it's an Indian company and it's made in India. So yeah, that's a big deal. So let's now have a look at this smartphone, guys. So guys, now let's have a look at this smartphone. This is the Micromax in 1B. You might have already heard about the Micromax Note 1, but this is like the small brother of it. But the small brother is actually more powerful, and you can also say that more value for money. Micromax in 1B comes with a better screen, it's a big screen, and the design at the back is also good. On this, we have the dual tone finish. I'll talk about this now. But guys, I really feel the specs and the features what you can find in this smartphone are probably better than Micromax in Note 1. So guys, if you want a better version of this one, you can go for the Micromax Note 1. Both of them are available in Flipkart. This Micromax in 1B is available in Flipkart. I'll leave the link of this if you want to purchase this via Flipkart is in the description box below. Okay, check it out. And even the detailed information and the specs are leaven in the description box below. You can check that out, guys. And guys, I have this smartphone. I'll review it. You have the share button. You have the subscribe button. You have the bell icon. And you have the like button. You have 4 times more buttons what I have. I just have the smartphone, guys. So it would be great if you press 1 button out of them. It would be superb if you press 2 out of them. It would be amazing if you press 3 out of them. And it would be simply astonishing if you press all the 4 out of all the 4 buttons, guys. Please do hit the subscribe button for this effort what I am doing. Okay, so now let's have a closer look at this smartphone, guys. Let me first give you a physical overview. At the back, this is plastic. This comes with a dual tone gradient finish, as you can see. But I really don't feel this is gradient. You can go for the purple one. I have bought this green color. Looks classic. But if you like, you can also go for the purple color. That has the better gradient color, and it looks better. And guys, you can have this feel at the back, as you can see, gives you a squeaking sound. And guys, this is matte and resists the fingerprints very well, guys. That is a thing I really like. And we have this fingerprint scanner at the back. I'll talk about that now. And guys, this is the camera setup over here. This has a 13 megapixel plus 2 megapixel rear facing camera with f1.8. It's shown here, and this is the flash. And here we have the Micromax branding written as in. And guys, this is at the back. This is the speaker. This is the on off button. It's good. This is the volume rocker. And guys, at this side, we have the SIM tray. This is the special Google button that is allotted for the Google. Because this runs on stock Android. So no nagware, no bloatware, no ads, just nothing. This gives you pure Android feel. At the down, you have a USB Type-C port. This is for charging. You get a 3.5 mm headphone jack and a microphone. And here you have the device speakers. This is the selfie camera that's of 8 megapixel, guys. And guys, this is a HD screen. And it would be great if they actually give a full HD screen, guys, because at this time, the time has changed and I think this is something they have to be improved. And you guys, can you see some dots over here? I think you have might have already guessed what are these. Yes, they are the gaps when I have applied the screen protector. They don't give you a case inside the box, but instead they give you this screen protector, what you can see over here. And guys, believe me, don't use this. This is of not a very good quality. And I just applied it over here to like just test it and see whether it's good or not. But this is, I think this would be obligatory because this is simply not good. And as you can see, after applying, yeah, lots of gaps over here. So yeah, that's something I think this quality can be improved, or you can simply replace this with a case because most of the people use a case, not the screen protector. And guys, yes, this instantly gets mini scratches over it. But the back, you have the mat and this screeching sound thing, which is good. But I don't like this labeling F1.8 and in. I think they could have kept this in and removed this F1.8 thing, guys, because this simply looks like a labeled diagram in a book. So I don't like this one. It's not a biology diagram, of course. So yeah, I think this would have, it would be great if they would have removed this F1.8. I really don't like this. And this line serves as a partition. So yeah, now let's test the speed of this back fingerprint scanner. And this unlocks this, as you can see. So yeah, I think the speed can be improved. Again, yeah, this got unlocked. And this got unlocked. Once more, for the last time. Sometimes this doesn't sense my finger. And this gives a vibration like my finger is actually, it doesn't recognize my finger. Like, see, that gives a vibration which like in most of the smartphones, you get it like if your the fingerprint is wrong. So at many times I thought I am placing it in the wrong way. But then I found out that this is actually gives a vibration and then unlocks. And that is a default setting. You cannot change it. Yeah, so yeah, that thing, I don't like this, and the speed can actually be improved because it's damn slow. I place it and yeah, takes about 2 seconds. So yeah, that's something which seriously can be improved, guys. So now let's go on to the screen and let me just turn this on. And guys, the thing I am very happy is for we are getting a stock Android experience over here. So yeah, that's actually very good, guys. And as you can see, and guys, the variant I have bought is a 64GB variant. So guys, this is the 64GB variant with 4GB of RAM. That's all for the physical overview. Now let's go to the technical specifications. And let me unlock this. Oh yeah, this got unlocked. And as you can see, that takes a lot of time. So yeah, guys, now the thing I'm happy is for, you get lots of quick toggles, and as it's pure Android, stock Android, you can directly screencast, you can Chromecast for different devices, and various modes you can get, like, and you even get nearby share. So yeah, that's good. And you get this invert color, so you go to this light theme. And guys, this looks pretty abrupt. So let me take this out. This is the dark mode. That's good. And you get this Bluetooth torch, everything. And night light, that is like your eye saver. And the storage, you can directly go to this storage that takes you this Google Files, guys. And yeah, this removes this chunk and everything. So yeah, you can surely have a look at that. And I have installed only some apps on this, like the Throttling Test, Hotstar, etc. And guys, let me tell you that this, you do not get, as it's a stock Android one, you don't get all the chunks. So, you get about 62 GB of storage. And like, you also get this YouTube Music, voice sound recorder, all of that. So, the default apps might cover around 1.7 GB, something like that. Basically, it eats about 2 GB of your storage, guys. So, yeah. Next, let's go to the next thing. That is, let me show you some camera samples that I have taken from this one. So guys, those were those camera samples. And guys, now let's take a look at the other features, what are there in this, and the features which might simply surprise you guys. So they are, first thing, this has a night mode in it. Yes, the camera has a night mode in it. At this price range, can you believe that? But I have not given any night mode sample because, you know, this is like, simply to say, they have just adjusted the camera to try to enlighten up the surroundings. It doesn't give you the natural feeling. In fact, that changes the colors into a green tone, which doesn't look good. It's like some military cameras, what you can see. This behaves like that. Not exactly like that, but doesn't give you that night feel. But yeah, in artificial conditions, in your rooms, this lightens up the room very good. And guys, the portrait shots are simply better than the portrait shots taken from other mobiles nowadays, like the Samsung mid-range smartphones or something like that. What I have tested, this performs better than those guys. So that was something I really It literally boomed up my mind. And guys, this has a 5000 mAh battery. By looking at this, you cannot think that this has a 5000 mAh battery because this is so sleek, feels very light in hand. And guys, this is simply very lightweight. So yeah, this is good. But how can this have a 5000 mAh battery? But let me tell you that is good. Because guys, this 5000 mAh battery should last up to at least one day, right? Yeah, this gives about one and a half day maximum of charge. So yeah, that's really good in this price range, what you're getting, the 5000 mAh battery. Really impressed of that. So guys, as you can see, there are many pros in this and many cons in this. So yeah, but let us go to the one of the important things. This has a Helio MediaTek G35 processor. So let's check the gaming. So guys, that was the gaming, and as you saw, this phone doesn't just get heated up while gaming, guys. This is something to note. I can put my hand freely. This is just not hot. So the tuning of the processor has been done very, very well, guys. And the thing I am happy again is for in Asa Fault, there were a lot of motion graphics, and it was basically a hardcore game. It was Asphalt 8 what I played. And guys, don't try to even play Asphalt 9. This phone cannot handle that. This doesn't have the capability to handle a game that is of 2.1 GB. And that is even more of more graphics. And that's a huge game. You cannot handle that. And in Asphalt 8, this managed all the graphics and everything very well, as you saw. So that was something I didn't expect. So I thought this would be normally like a normal low-end smartphone. But yeah, this behaved like a mid-range sort of a phone in this category also. So this managed Asphalt 8 very well. I played, there were absolutely no frame drops. But as you saw in Call of Duty, the frame rate was very, very poor. It's standard 60 Hz, but in the frame rate was so poor. There were so many lags in between, stucking, and the frame drops were just countless. At every time I shooted, every time I turn around, there were some of the frame drops. It got stuck, and then I had lags when I was shooting, when it was reloading the gun. So yeah, there were a lot of frame drops, and because Call of Duty, you know, it's an even big game with lots of shooting and everything. So guys, yeah, this phone cannot handle that Call of Duty very well. But yeah, if you are a normal gamer who plays on everyday games and you do all this stuff on the phone, all the text stuff, whatever, then this would handle it very well. But yeah, if you are a gamer who you can play at high quality, you cannot play at high quality and high frame rate in Call of Duty, you have to sacrifice either of them. I think you can sacrifice that high quality in Call of Duty, then you can do a very good gaming with a good frame rate. But I think this one, like if you are a gamer who does at very good gaming and you want a bit of gaming centric smartphone in overall thing, then I think I don't suggest this smartphone in terms of gaming, guys, because this simply cannot handle that. Guys, now let's check the, and now let me just tell me about the speakers and this microphone, guys. So guys, coming to the microphone and speakers, the microphone quality is good, just like any other smartphone, and the device speakers at the top are very good, and again, like normal, they are normal. I don't have any problem with them. But this speaker at the back, I think at budget smartphones, speakers are not provided over here because simply they cost more. But I think when we are getting so many things, and guys, I forgot to tell you, this is an IPS LCD screen. When we are getting all those things, I think we could get this speaker over here, guys, because this speaker, I don't know how to describe it. But let me tell you, in normal world, it's just average or bad, even I can tell like that. Because the speaker quality wasn't very good. I think you have already observed in gaming. The speaker quality, the tones become blurred and the voice gets stringed. So yeah, if you put this at high volume, like it would be better if you like stop the music or cinema, whatever you are watching. Because the voice what you get and the tones, they simply get shrinked, guys, and that doesn't sound well. And that sounds like you are watching, if you are watching some song, it would be like a shooting game what you are doing. So yeah, I am not very happy with this speaker. I think they could have simply put it here, and they could have used a good quality speaker. When you are getting so many good things in such a price range, I think this would be a minor one. And let me again play some of the music for you to again get an idea, guys. And yeah, you catch the phone like this, so it blocks the speaker at the back, and if you keep it like this, that just creates a mess, guys. So guys, playing some copyright free sounds, just don't fall into all those copyright infringements. So yeah, let's listen to this now. So guys, that was normal speaker, and now let me keep this down like this. So now the figure is facing the ground. So guys, as you saw, when I have kept this down, the sound what you got, just 20% of it just got gone, because it was facing the ground, so you don't get that much sound outside. So that's something I think that can be seriously improved in the next generation. This can be brought over here, guys. That's serious thing, that's a serious problem. So guys, finally coming to the last test on this smartphone, which determines what this smartphone actually is, that is the benchmark test and the throttling test. So yeah, let me do the throttling test and we'll see the results. So guys, now as you can see, the throttling test is over and the processor is surely tuned in a very good way. It's really amazing. As you can see, the average score what you have got is of 90,000. So yeah, for a low end smartphone, this is very good. So yeah, this smartphone, I have to say that you can do everything what you do in other smartphones very well, because the scores are really of very good, guys. The maximum score went up to 94,000. So yeah, I'm really impressed with this score, guys. So now let's test the benchmark on this one, guys. So guys, now I have run this benchmark on this one. So the total score what we get is 10,014 points. So what we have to get for a low-end smartphone is actually 9,450 accurately. And here we have got 10,014. So yeah, this has taken the edge. And this says that it was 1.42 times faster. So yeah, that is good at this price range. In fact, that is surprising. Now let me test a proper benchmark. We have Geekbench over here, Geekbench 5. So this is a proper benchmarking testing with this app. So let me run this also now. So guys, as you can see, I'm running Geekbench over here, and the thing I want to tell you is that now this phone has got a bit heated up, and guys, after doing gaming and throttling test, then benchmark test, and as I told, Geekbench is a proper benchmark to test the benchmark. It's a proper app to test the benchmark, and now it's not able to compat with this Geekbench, so it's taking a lot of time. It's already has been 10 minutes, and the maximum time Geekbench says is 10 minutes to complete. But this now the phone has no capacity to work more. So I'm just cancelling this test. And God, look, and at the back, this has got heated up enough. So guys, now you might have got an idea what this phone is and what are the pros and cons, and how what is the phone is compatible of. But I have to say, really, that is great to give these many features in such a smartphone. And guys, that's all for this video. If you like my video, do not forget to hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, and share this video to everyone you know, so that at this time they can buy this smartphone, this amazing smartphone, if you are in a need of a good smartphone in a value for money. This I have to say, this is more value for money, what they say. This phone is simply amazing. I think this phone is one of my favorite smartphones now. I have never expected such a great phone in such a price range. Hats off to Micromax, and I hope Micromax brings the next generation of this smartphones like this. If Micromax, people of Micromax are watching this video, I really thank Micromax for empowering India with such a great smartphone like this. And guys, if you want to support my channel, please hit the subscribe button, hit the like button. I'm saying this too much, but please do encourage us for the hard work what we are making. And guys, thanks for supporting us for 1 year now. And I hope to see you in my next video, guys. Take care, guys.